And now I would like to ask Michelle Jacobo, our Student Council Vice President, to come up and say the pledge.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
And now we have the following students, led by Karen Tice for the Star Spangled Banner: Lexi Goldman, Amanda Knott, Lauren Mason, Cynthia Soto, Layla Urbina, and Allison Young. Thank you. You may be seated. So I would like to start this evening by thanking the Romeoville High School ROTC for their presentation of the flags. Michelle Jacobo, our Student Council Vice President, who led us in the pledge, and our student choir for singing in the national anthem. Before we begin our ceremony this evening, I would like to take a moment and thank you for coming out tonight to support our 8th grade class of 2015. The students did a wonderful job practicing today and are eagerly awaiting the moment when they get to hear their name called. One of the expectations we have of our students is that they remain quiet during the entire ceremony, and we ask that you all help us achieve a dignified ceremony by holding your applause until the end of the ceremony. We ask this so that we can allow all names to be heard. We thank you in advance for holding your cheering and applause to the end of the ceremony out of respect for our students. And we also ask that you silence your cell phones at this time. I'd like to introduce our esteemed guests this evening who will be assisting with the presentation of our diplomas. First, we have a school board member, Dan Felice. Assistant Superintendent Gary Grisafi, in charge of finance. Our eighth grade counselor, Anita Hilton. And our assistant principal, Bill Normand. And now, hopefully with the most applause and the most important introduction, good evening, 8th grade class of 2015. So I'd like to welcome everybody in the stands to our middle school promotion ceremony for A Vito Martinez Middle School. You may have noticed as the class of 2015 were processing into the gymnasium that the first 57 students were donned with yellow cords. These cords are to signify students who were inducted into the National Junior Honor Society 2 weeks ago. These students had maintained a 3.5 grade point average. They've demonstrated positive behavior and most notably have contributed at least 50 hours of service to their community. In your programs, these students have been noted with an asterisk. Congratulations to these individuals for their accomplishments. Now I would like to recognize the 230 students we have all come out to celebrate this evening. I'm honored to say they've met all of the requirements to promote to high school next year. Each student sitting before you has passed all of their core content classes. They've demonstrated our Viking values of respect, responsibility, and positive relationships. And lastly, they have passed both the U.S. and Illinois Constitution tests. You'll soon be hearing from three of our students about their experiences here at AVM, and they will also be talking to you about the importance of character. Last month, I had the chance to attend the Illinois Principals Association breakfast, where we were able to honor two of our students, Lauren Mason and Eric Nelson, for their hard work and academic excellence throughout middle school. The guest speaker for the event also shared a message about the importance of character, and he read a quote from Mother Teresa that I'd like to share with all of you. Her message is about true character and how our actions define us as individuals. Mother Teresa quotes, "People are often unreasonable, irrational, and self-centered. Forgive them anyway. If you are kind, people may accuse you of selfish, ulterior motives. Be kind anyway. If you are successful, you will win unfaithful friends and some genuine enemies. Succeed anyway. If you are honest and sincere, people may deceive you. Be honest and sincere anyway. What you spend years creating, others could destroy overnight. Create anyway. If you find serenity and happiness, some may be jealous. Be happy anyway. The good you do today will often be forgotten. Do good anyway. Give the best you have, and it will never be enough. Give your best anyway. In the final analysis, it is between you and God. It was never between you and them anyway." I don't think anyone could have said better words than those words by Mother Teresa. Students, as we celebrate the accomplishments you have achieved and acknowledge the many opportunities you have before you, keep in mind the importance of character. Be true to yourself and focus your energies on your actions and words, for these will be what define you. Now I'd like to introduce our first speaker, Emily Hughes.
I am Emily Hughes, and I have written many pieces during my time as an eighth grade student. And most of the time, my words seem to flow pretty naturally. But this speech is simply the most difficult thing I've had to write all year. Whenever I have trouble writing anything, I always find myself looking to others for inspiration. And in my search for that inspiration, I found a lot of quotes on what I decided my speech would be about. Kindness. Instead of choosing just one, I chose a few quotes that I think will do the speech a lot of justice. "Your greatness is measured by your kindness, your education and intellect by your modesty. Your ignorance is betrayed by your suspicions and prejudices, and your real caliber is measured by the consideration and tolerance you have for others." William J.H. Botker. Unexpected kindness is the most powerful, least costly, and most underrated agent of human change. Bob Carey. Too often, we underestimate the power of a touch, a smile, a kind word, a listening ear, an honest compliment, or the smallest act of caring, all of which have the potential to turn a life around. Leo Buscaglia. All of these quotes have to do with building your character, which you heard about from Ms. DiDonato's speech. But more specifically, they have to do with building kindness into your character. I cannot emphasize how truly important it is to be kind, or how truly important it is to have hold of one small piece of kindness and use it for the greater good of others by putting forth one small act of that kindness, such as a smile. You can change a course of someone's life completely with one modest deed. I found an interesting and rather moving story about a man who took his life by jumping off of the Golden Gate Bridge. Later that day, as the police were searching his house, they found a note that read, "Today I will walk to the bridge. If anyone smiles at me, I won't jump." Perhaps this man had lost faith that there was and is still tenderness in a world that has gone seemingly cold. But we all have the potential to ignite and attend a warm fire in someone's heart. Perhaps this man had also looked into the eyes of a devilish monster and shuddered with a confused fear because he couldn't figure out why someone hadn't fought the battle for morality with him. He then let that monster take his last bit of hope and happiness. Yet, something that blew me away was that if he said anyone, if anyone smiles at me, he wouldn't jump. If you pull the word anyone apart, you'll find that it is anyone, possibly referring to any one person. Can you believe that? Just one person had the power to change what he might have thought was his fate. And my friends, all of you hold the very same power. You hold the power to help stop a monster with a weapon so easily equipped, such as a smile. A small but powerful act of kindness. In a moment of honesty, if I were to take my place of my train of thought a few months ago, I would have never seen myself standing here in front of all of you, giving a speech about something so incredibly in absolutely everyone's life. But during that rough time, I received an extensive amount from compassion from the few benevolent people I held and continue to hold close to me. I have since strived to be more like those people so that others may know their worth, their true potential, and their ability to achieve a life of happiness. I thoroughly encourage all of you to do the very same, to do small things that can and most likely will reach much greater heights than you ever thought imaginable, such as holding the door open, complimenting someone, perhaps a stranger, and smiling at the people you know, the people you come in contact with, and the people you pass, not only to spread love, grace, and tenderness, but also because each one of you here has a genuinely delightful smile, and I'm sure that someone in your life, including myself, deeply wants to see that smile and feel that kindness. It is my honor to introduce our next speaker, Jose Cano.
Live as if you were to die tomorrow. Learn as if you were to live forever. Mahatma Gandhi. These words have kept me going. I hope mine give you the same feeling. Hello, everyone. My name is Jose Cano. I am here because I have been asked not only to give a speech, but to also say farewell to this chapter of our lives. I've seen many of you go through a lot. I've seen you laugh, cry, and get mad. Failure has always been one of our worst fears, either in games, all the way to the classroom. The fact that you can still try your hardest and not necessarily succeed, that is a very hard lesson for everyone to learn. Today, you have overcome your fears. These 3 years of hard work had finally paid off. It sure wasn't easy, and I'd be lying if I said the brand new chapter will be easier. We all have our own struggles, We all have our own personalities. We all are unique. Some of us, not a lot, just some of us graduating today, came into this school as strangers. And as the years passed, we all became friends, even enemies at some point. But on this day, we are ending this year as a family. I encourage every single one of you to keep moving forward and accomplish whatever you want in life. Do whatever makes you happy. I want to thank Mrs. Kazmia and Mrs. Amade, both for helping me be able to come up here and make my speech happen. Without them, I wouldn't know what to say. I also want to thank Mrs. DiDonato for giving me this opportunity to come up here with our two other outstanding classmates. I want to thank all the teachers, all the way from kindergarten to now, that have helped my classmates and I make it this far. You have given us your time, your strength, and most of all, you believed in us, and we are gratefully thankful. When I first started at AVM, I didn't have high expectations for myself, so I didn't think I would become anything special. I had no dreams for when I grew up. But as Harriet Tubman once said, every great dream begins with a dreamer. Always remember you have within you the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars, to change the world. As hopefully as we grow up to become adults like the ones around us, you will understand that you are capable of becoming big and bad as the celebrities we look up to. So while we go to school, learn as much as you can while you are young, since life becomes too busy later. As we go into high school and grow up, it is crucial that we know how our lives are important. It is your life to live. So understand that everything you choose to do is leading to who you want to become. There are three simple rules in life for me. 1, if you do not go after what you want, you'll never have it. 2, if you do not ask, the answer will always be no. 3, if you do not move forward, you'll always be in the same place. So go after what you want. Ask questions along the way. And most of all, move forward. With moving forward, you learn. Learning is knowledge. Knowledge is power. Power is respect. Respect is happiness. I'm sure we all want to be happy in the end. I'm sure all the parents here are happy with what they have in front of them. You've all heard of John Lennon. Yes? If not, he was in the Beatles. And he once said, "When I was 5 years old, my mother would always tell me that happiness is the key to life. When I went to school, they asked me what I wanted to be when I grew up. I wrote down, happy. They told me I did not understand the assignment. I told them they didn't understand life. What I got from these 3 years, no. From all my life up till now, is that you can only be happy with yourself. I am, for now. I'm sure you all are. So in the end, all that should make you happy is how you turned out to be and what you did while you lived. It is my honor to present the next speaker, our student council president, Avanti Love.
Good evening, fellow staff members, family, and friends. I believe it is an honor for me to stand up here and speak to all of you at our 8th grade promotion ceremony. It feels like just yesterday, I was walking through those elementary school doors holding my mom's hand in 1st grade. The day after that, I was graduating 5th grade. I remember my mom saying to me, "Wow, you're going to the middle school. My baby is growing up." I'm pretty sure that most of us felt the same way walking into 6th grade. out of our comfort zone, nervous, and just a bit awkward. We weren't used to certain things in elementary school, from changing in gym to switching classes every 45 minutes. To us, this was a big shift. With each passing year, we all got more and more accustomed to this school. Majority of us got involved in many after-school clubs, sports, and activities, whether it was track, basketball, and soccer, or ecology club, facts club, or fishing club. This all resulted to us making a ton of new friends and wonderful relationships. I'm sure that we can all admit that we were worried for nothing. Sure, we all were stressed over the years with projects, tests, and other things. But looking back at it now, it was a breeze. All it required was a bit of patience. Now we head to high school, a new beginning for us all. New classmates, better grades, and different teachers. Because of this, there is no reason for any of us not to succeed. Although this is just eighth grade, this is still a major point in our early life. These 4 years in high school are critical to our education. This may determine what college or career we want to pursue when we leave, so we must remember to take it seriously. But the one thing we can't possibly forget is to have fun. It's going to be absolutely impossible for us to go through this high school without enjoying it. With high school comes many new opportunities. You get to learn more about yourself, meet new people, and try new things middle school wasn't able to offer. Remember how you would join a club and there would only be about 20 people? Now in high school, there will be 50 more people, and half of them you haven't even met yet. In this process of meeting new people, we have to focus on our character. In other words, we have to think to ourselves what others are going to remember us by. Are people going to remember us by the kid who never bothered to put any effort in anything he or she did? Or the kid who worked hard in everything he or she did? So with that being said, there are a lot more people to meet and a lot more goals to achieve. Walt Disney once said, "All our dreams can come true if we have the courage to pursue them." For a lot of people, high school may seem scary or discouraging, but in reality, it's just another step to reaching all the things we want and hope to become. As sixth graders, many of us were intimidated by many different things, such as passing periods and not wanting to be late to class, the schoolwork, older students, and making new friends. One of my experiences would be when I had to run from the sixth grade hallway all the way down to the little theater in the eighth grade hallway just so I wouldn't be late to art class. As seventh graders, we came in feeling a bit more confident in ourselves. We felt like we had a little more power throughout the school. Now as eighth graders, we felt wiser, stronger, and maybe even untouchable. Okay, I'm sorry. The same thing is going to happen to us within high school. We're going to start at the bottom, feeling the same way as we did in sixth grade, climbing our way to the top. Coming in as the best group of freshmen Romeoville High School has ever seen, we have to set our marks there and make ourselves unforgettable. During these school years, we have to keep in mind that time flies, and we are going to soon have to make our dreams and life goals our reality. Now, class of 2015, I mean class of 2019, let's make these last few moments of eighth grade count, because soon it's all going to be over, and we're all going to have a brand new start as incoming freshmen. Each and every one of us has the potential to be anything we desire, whether we believe it or not. It was an honor to serve as sixth grade representative, seventh grade representative, and eighth grade president. Goodbye, A Vito Martinez Middle School.
Some pretty amazing words from some pretty amazing students, and that is just a sample of the amazing students we have in front of us. I'd like to give those three students a round of applause again. Before we begin reading the names for this evening's promotion ceremony, I would like to make one brief announcement that please note rows A through E. We'll be meeting you in the cafeteria after all students have exited the gymnasium, and rows F through J will be meeting in the little theater unless you have made arrangements with your child to meet outside. So just so there's not a bottleneck in the hallway. So now I'd like to introduce our assistant principal, Mr. Bill Normand, to read our names.
If we could refrain from clapping till all the names are called, we would greatly appreciate it one more time. Are we ready? Sharaf Abatuleb. Mato Ajegu. David Alfaro. Kelvin Asamoah. Ariana Baez. Katie Beckman. Brandon Bell. Samuel Belmonte. Antonia Brown. Ashley Cobena Bravo. Damian Contreras. Angela Spinner. Joshua DePago. Jasmine Deep. Brittany Dorch. Matthew Erickson. Ryan Ferguson. Celeste Flores. Hunter Frost. Angel Garcia Diaz. Heather Gerard. Elizabeth Gora. Jaden Gutierrez. Emily Hughes. Michelle Jacobo. Jacoby Jones. Alyssa Kruger. Emily LaPerry. Lynette Lopez. Avante Love. Zachary Manuel. Mackenzie Marquez. Lauren Mason. Vincent Mason. Javier Mendez. Eric Nelson. Julianne Nemenzo. Gwyn Nguyen. Kevin Jericho Passes. Matthew Peralta. Derek Perkins. Jada Perry. Jalen Perry. Jason Pineda. Hannah Ramos. Kaylee Rice. Mary Ritterhoff. Sebastian Rodriguez. Hunter Samoy. Marley Serrano. Adonijah Sims. Renee Tran. Claudia Vasquez. Alexis Vasquez. Tyler Wallace. Victor Zatorski. Emily Zimmer. Afolabi Akande. Crystal Alcala. Fernando Alcala. Jenna Almodovar. Christian Alvarado. Austin Ammons. Marcin Antilak. Edwin Arcos. Asfia Arfola. Aiden Asensio. Stephen Bain. Jada Baker. Angelique Ballard. Tamara Hudson. Cynthia Barraza. Talia Bennett. Samantha Bestwina. Sarah Bestwina. Tavion Blackwell. Emily Bliss. Monique Bradshaw. George Calvillo. Jose Cano. Giovanni Carmona. Zachary Carr. Aaron Casas. Marco Castillo. Juan Ceballos. Brandon Cerritos. Christian Chavez. Armando Corral. Katrina Cotton. Noah Davis. Liliana De Leon. Anthony De Hoyos. Bianca Delgado Melchor. James Dirdzinski. Anthony Diaz. Rayvon Douglas. Anthony Duarte. Destiny Dunkirk. Aaron Eaton. Julian Flores. Riley Ford. Morgan Franzen. Matt Fudala. Julio Galindo. Braulio Galvez. Carmen Galvez. Gloria Gandarilla. Gustavo Garza Jr. Giselle Giannoni. Deontay Gibson. Madison Giza. Eber Gonzalez. Montserrat Gonzalez. Jasmine Gonzalez Chavez. Carolina Gujelik. Christian Guzman. Mariam Hanna. Quadim Hardy. Riley Hartches. Adolfo Hernandez Sotelo. Alyssa Herrera. Matthew Hildebrand. Anaya Hilliard. Marcus Hollins Jr. Brianna Holm. Iru Igbenovia. Najman Hasia Issa. Sergio Jimenez. Paris Jones. Michael Jungles. Kevin Karikari. Natalie Kuczynski. LaShanti LaFleur. Jose De Leon, Jose Leon. Matthew Lessentine. Davion Lewis. Gage Linton. Stephen Lopez. Cameron Love. William Maldonado. Maya Manzano. Robert Mark. Victoria Mars. Christian Martinez. Daniel Mata. Walter Matrapula. Kylie Mayfield. Riley McKinney. Michaela McLaughlin. Eileen Melendez. Francis Mendoza. Vernita Mensa. Treasure Middleton. Carver Miller. Julian Minguez. Marcos Miranda. Nathaniel Montoya. Juliana Marino. Alexia Marin. David Munoz. Elizabeth Munoz. Vincenzo Nelson. Marlon Ochoa. Ivan Olivo. Christian Ortiz. Marbit Padilla. Naomi Palomar. Jeffrey Pareja. Dawson Patterson. Layla Peoples. Hold up. Brian Perez. Roberto Pineda. Manuel Quezada. Jesus Quiles. Joseph Quirk. Tyler Ranieri. Jordan Reed. Anais Renteria. Eric Reyes. Alexis Rivas. Henry Rocha. Jesse Rodriguez. Kayla Rodriguez. Michael Rodriguez. Yendi Rosas. Matthew Ruland. Angel Sanchez. Yosemarie Sanchez. Cody Schaff. Angela Scholes. Daniel Scholes. Samantha Scholes. Alexis Segura. Sally Sintem.
Marisha? Hold on.
Marisha Soriano. Cynthia Soto. Kinga Stahursky. Jessica Stowe. Jacob Sudol. Kevin Swartz. Destiny Sykes. Brian Terria. Jacob Teodoro.
Hold on a second.
Jessica Thomas. Shania Thompson. Brian Tinoco. James Tulis. Daniel Torres. Kayla Torres. Evelyn Trado. Tyler Trevino. Thomas Ushashevsky. Raul Valdez. Jesse Valle. Anthony Vallejo. Steven Vallejo. Adrian Vargas Bernal. Alonzo Vasquez. Anai Velarde. Aaliyah Vergara. Adair Viramontes. Justin Werner. Caitlin Whalen. Jabril Williams. Tristan Worley. Cameron Warner. Glenn Wright. Jonathan Iacco. Elena Zamora. Alejandra Zavala Sandoval.
Congratulations to the class of 2015. And now please stay in the stands until all students have exited for our recessional. Thank you.